faster than a summer break, stronger than a teacher's bladder, able to engage all students in a single lesson. It is a hoot! And now to our story. One day, as Hazel Hoot was flying home after a hard day of helping students, she heard the familiar sounds of a teacher in distress.
This looks like a job for Hazel Hoot. I have just the thing for you, an Astute Hoot sight license. You now have access to engaging supplemental resources that enhance your existing curriculum. My hope is that these resources will help you work smarter, not harder, and that you too will awaken the joy of learning in your students. Let me guide you through these amazing resources. First, log into your account. Next, go to the Reading Strategies tab in the Shop by Subject drop-down menu. Then, go to a product you would like to download and click on the Site License button in the description. Finally, click on the downloaded file on the bottom of the page. Save to your computer. With the site license, you have access to all of the resources in the Reading and Math Strategy tabs. Each unit includes a table of contents that outlines the resources provided for each unit. This allows you to easily select the components needed for your lesson. Let me give you an example of how to incorporate one of my reading strategy units into your classroom. Step 1. Choose an anchor text for the reading lesson from your district curriculum or Common Core exemplar list. Today, I'll be using Frog and Toad Together. Step 2. Select a focus strategy based on assessment data, grade level standards, and your scope and sequence. For this lesson, I'll focus on visualization as the main comprehension strategy, so I'll use resources from the Vern the Visualizing Vulture unit. Step 3. Prepare text-dependent questions and select targeted academic vocabulary. Choose questions that promote rich literary discussions and engaging conversations. Step 4. Utilize appropriate graphic organizers and reproducibles included within each strategy animal unit, such as ICANN posters, worksheets, and anchor charts. Step 5. Create reading response journals to provide an opportunity for students to respond to text and writing. This is great for independent work and homework. Step 6. Incorporate the built-in assessment tools to monitor student progress. Here is an example of a rubric you can use. It is also helpful to analyze work samples and use customized comprehension quizzes. To further assist you, download the Ultimate Guided Reading Planning Templates for additional tools. Let me show you how to use my math problem-solving units now. Step 1. Select a problem-solving focus strategy based on assessment data, grade level standards, and your scope and sequence. Today, I will use Tom the Tabling Turtle for our example. Step 2. Choose the appropriate problem-solving templates and word problems. All units include a variety of word problems, differentiated problem-solving journal templates, ICANN posters, anchor charts, and more to provide scaffolding and support. Step 3. Use discussion prompts and questions to promote collaborative mathematical conversations and flexible thinking. Essential questions, self-reflection stems, and discussion prompts are included. Step 4. Incorporate built-in assessment tools. Use the rubric provided to analyze journal samples to determine student growth and points of misunderstanding. Helping other teachers and students is our passion, and we are excited to contribute to your classroom success. Our hope is that these resources will help you work smarter, not harder, and that you will see the same joy of learning as we see in our students, as the most reluctant students blossom into motivated, enthusiastic learners. Connect with us on social media to see the strategy animals in action in our classroom. We also have freebies and lots of helpful tips. We'd love to see the strategy animals in use in your classroom too. Tag us in a pic.